Higher education institutes in West Bengal are known for their vibrant, sometimes violent, political culture. However, recently the political epicenter in campuses has shifted from student politics to the usual source of political tamasha in the state, that is the office of the governor and the state government. Now, the acrimonious relationship between West Bengal Governor Jagdeep Dhankar and Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee is known to all. The latest manifestation of this is when the state government denied the governor, who is the chancellor of all state-aided universities, the permission to hold a virtual conference with the vice-chancellors of 21 universities, which was scheduled for 15th July. According to the governor, the government allegedly said that there are no provisions for virtual conference with vice-chancellors under the rules and that the same was not required. Since then, the governor, at a rate of at least 3 tweets a day, has been emphasizing about how student issues are high priority for him. This is not the first time that the Trinamool Congress government and the governor have locked horns on who runs the state-aided universities in West Bengal. Almost all of these times, it is the vice-chancellors and their allegiance that has become the bone of contention. For example, earlier this year, the governor had called a meeting with the vice-chancellors of all 21 state-run universities at the Raj Bhavan. In an epic snub, not even one vice-chancellor turned up. According to a PTI report, when asked why he didn't attend a meeting, a vice-chancellor apparently said that he had other commitments. Seriously? Other commitments? Others stated that the West Bengal Universities and Colleges Act, Administration and Regulation 2017 does not allow for a meeting between a vice-chancellor and the chancellor without a nod from the Higher Education Department. In June this year, the Burdwan University had two pro-vice-chancellors for a while. First, in a notification from the Raj Bhavan, the governor appointed Professor Gautam Chandra as the pro-vice-chancellor of the university in a move that did not have the consent of the state government. The state government hit back, calling the governor a BJP man. And just a few hours after the Raj Bhavan notification put out its own notification appointing Dr. Ashish Kumar Panigrahi as the new pro-VC of Burdwan University. Now, according to the rules, the chancellor has to take a decision regarding any university appointment from a list given to him by the state government. The governor, on the other hand, says that he just has to consult the state government and not follow their diktat, giving rise to what can only be described as a clash of egos amidst which the functioning of a university is stuck. Dhankar eventually bowed out, saying that this is not the opportune time for controversies in the education system. This ego tussle led to another controversy recently when the governor show-caused the vice-chancellor of the Cooch Bihar Panchana and Burma University for not being able to, and I quote, take appropriate, legally mandated, necessary steps by way of information to the chancellor who has authority to preside over the convocation, unquote. Basically, the governor took offense to not being invited to the convocation of this university, which he says he is legally mandated to attend. While we agree that not inviting the governor may, just may, be disrespectful, does it really merit a show cause? Well, not if one goes by the University Act. We took a look at the order from the Raj Bhavan and it merely states that the Vice-Chancellor has been show-caused under Section 9(7) of the Cooch Bihar Panchana and Burma University Act. This act only states that the governor has the power to show-cause and remove a Vice-Chancellor if he is convinced, amongst other things, of dereliction of duty and politically partisan behaviour. Nowhere does the act mention, however, that the governor has to preside over administrative events such as the convocation. The governor's rishta with not being able to attend convocations is, however, quite purana. In the past, he's also had to exit the Calcutta University convocation after mass protests at the venue. This was the same convocation in which Nobel laureate Abhijit Banerjee was scheduled to get an honorary doctorate. The governor had also faced a similar situation in Jadavpur University. So, why these protests, why these log jams, and why this interference in the functioning of vice-chancellors? We took all these questions to Governor Jagdeep Dhankar and this is what he had to say.
I am very clear. If a vice-chancellor does not go by the diktat of the chancellor, he will face consequences in law. And I am sure they must be fully aligned to it. These things can be withstood only up to a limit. If vice-chancellors think that someone in the government can protect them even after they commit an act of indiscretion or disobedience to the directive of the chancellor, they may be in for serious surprise.
Why do you think these student protests are happening? There's of course the politics of it on one side, which is from the Bengal government. But why are these student protests happening?
Not the students. Please, for heaven's sake, don't bring students.
Okay.
If you are witness to it.
So
10-20 people don't constitute students. Who saved the day for Calcutta University? It was your governor. If I had not signed the delete, could it have been given? Unless I had signed it, it could not have been given to the Nobel laureate. He was present, his mother was present.
You met him also, I believe.
No, he met me. I cannot hurt the feeling of Bengali mind. I cannot hurt the feeling of Bengali intellect. I thought for their sake, for their, they are Bhadra Purush. I said, let me bend. I bend for whom? Not for hooliganism. Not for those who were a small group engaged in violence. I bent for the sublimity and richness of Bengali culture. A Bengali mind would expect from me. Make sacrifice.
While the governor does face criticism from many quarters for going beyond his mandate to interfere in the functioning of institutes of higher education, to be fair, the West Bengal government has also gone beyond its regular functioning to clip his wings as the Chancellor of state-run universities. Like in 2019, when a gazette notification said that all communication between the Chancellor and the Vice-Chancellors has to be routed through the Higher Education Department. The notification also stated that the universities will have the power to call meetings of their highest decision-making bodies without consulting the Chancellor. It abolished the Chancellor's Secretariat, curbed his powers in taking action against and removing Vice-Chancellors, and even reduced his powers in choosing Vice-Chancellors. Additionally, ever since the beginning of the Trinamool Congress regime in 2011, the government has been accused of various lapses in the way they run their universities. This includes not handling student politics well, as is enunciated by the Hope Cholera movement of 2014 after police brutality in the Jadavpur University campus. There have also been instances where the state government has allowed law and order situations to form in campuses and has also not been transparent about the appointment of vice chancellors and other administrative positions. We tried to reach out to State Education Minister Partho Chatterjee for a comment on all of this, but have not received a response to our interview request.